This is session 8, Organize the Timeline. Organizing the project timeline is as simple as moving clips, or as complex as compound clips and auditions. This movie provides a variety of basic techniques. Chapter 9 covers these in much more detail. In this movie, you'll learn how to select, deselect, disable, and delete clips. We'll learn how to move clips in the primary storyline, how to move connected clips, and how to add markers and to-dos. But before we can start moving, we gotta start with the basics, and that means with a selection. You select something, and you do something to it. The biggest editing concept to get used to with Final Cut 10 is the magnetic timeline. Basically, this prevents accidental gaps from occurring in the timeline by snapping clips together as though they were magnets. Most of the time, we don't want gaps between clips because they cause flashes of black. However, when you do, there is an easy way to move clips and leave gaps. It's called the position tool. So let me show you how to select, deselect, disable, and delete clips. Then we'll move clips in the primary storyline. We'll move connected clips, we'll display a clip full screen, and we'll set, name, delete, and jump to markers. Everything starts with a selection. For instance, to select a clip, just click on it. Notice the yellow box around it. That means that clip is selected. To deselect it, click below it. Same thing in the viewer. Click on a clip, notice the yellow box appears around it. To deselect it, click anywhere outside the selected area. We can click on any clip that we want to select. But what happens if we want to select more than one clip? Easiest way to do this is to click above or below the range of clips you want to select. I tend to go above, and drag out a rectangular marquee. Whatever that marquee touches becomes selected. To deselect again, click below it. We could also use some keyboard shortcuts. We'll click on an arbitrary clip, hold the Shift key down, click on the ending clip, and when you Shift click, you select a range of clips. And now all the clips from the first to the last clip are selected. Or hold the Command key down. And now with the Command key, we can click on any arbitrary collection of clips. They don't even have to be touching. Notice here I have 5 selected clips, but none of them are next to each other. We could select all the clips by typing Command A. That selects everything. And we can deselect everything by typing Shift Command A. Now you'll notice that I'm using the playhead. That's because for me, I like the fact that when I let go of the playhead, it doesn't move. If I turn skimming on, remember the keyboard shortcut is the letter S, wherever I move the cursor, the skimmer moves with it. And far too often I'm focused on what the playhead is doing. I forget the skimmer is on and, well, let me illustrate. If skimming is off and the playhead is in a clip, if you type the letter C, it selects whatever clip the playhead is in, the letter C. But if skimming is turned on and I've got the playhead over here and I want to select this particular clip, but the skimmer's way the heck over here, when I type C, the skimmer has priority over the playhead. And wherever the skimmer is, that's what gets selected. Notice that the skimmer is orange and the playhead is gray. Orange indicates which has precedence over the other. Turn skimming off and notice the playhead goes orange, indicating that the playhead has precedence. And wherever the playhead is, that clip becomes selected. C selects whatever clip the playhead is in unless skimming is on, in which case it selects whatever clip the skimmer is in. Well, thinking about selecting, let's put our playhead here, for instance, and watch that glass being shaped. One of the things that we often want to do is to be able to hide a clip, for instance, to see or hear a clip below it. If the playhead is in a clip, type the letter V. V turns visibility on and off. Type the letter V to bring it back. It's a toggle. A clip is visible or invisible, audible or inaudible. The letter V toggles that on and off. Another thing we often want to do is to move a clip. To move a clip, simply grab it and drag it. When the magnetic timeline is on, you're moving clips as whole clips between clips. You can't drop a clip in the middle of a clip. If I select a range of clips and move them, notice that the magnets in the magnetic timeline snap the clips back to each other. Well, what happens if I want to move the clips and leave a gap? You can't do it with the arrow tool. But you can, when you click on the toolbar, which is an area of the interface we haven't looked at yet, we can move clips with the position tool. Keyboard shortcut is the letter P. When I grab clips with the position tool and move them, the clips move and that gap is replaced with an entity, a thing, a clip called a gap. A gap is TV safe black, completely silent audio, and just as we can move clips, we can also move gaps. I switch back to the arrow tool and I can drag this gap wherever I want it to go. When the position tool is active, we have disabled the magnets. When the arrow tool is active, the magnets are enabled. To delete a clip, highlight it, press the big delete key. That deletes the clip and closes the gap between clips. To do that again, highlight, hit the delete key. Well, what happens if I want to delete the clip and leave a gap? If you have a full-size keyboard, press the small delete key, the one right next to the end key. That deletes the clip and leaves a gap. For those of you on smaller keyboards or laptops, the small delete key is the same as holding the FN key down and pressing the big delete key. I can delete a range of clips, simply select them, press the big delete key. I really recommend using the big delete key because it gives you the results that you want. Highlight the clips, press the big delete key, and they're gone. Press the small delete key, the clips are gone and are replaced with a gap. If I grab a clip and drag it up to convert it from the primary storyline to become a connected clip, I can drag this clip wherever I want at any time. No magnets apply, because what determines the position of the clip is where it's connected, that little spiky thing right there. So moving clips that are connected, there is no magnetic timeline. When you're in the primary storyline, there is always a magnetic timeline, unless you're using the position tool. By the way, you want to know how you can have a clip go full screen? Type Shift Command F. Wherever the playhead is, we see that image full screen. Hit the space bar to stop, space bar to play, the J key to go backwards, K to stop, L to go forwards. The up and down arrow keys work exactly the same. In other words, all the keyboard shortcuts that we've grown used to inside the timeline work exactly the same in full screen mode. It's just now we're looking at a much larger picture. And you press the escape key to get back out. I'm really struck by the drama of this scene. Barehanded, holding just a cloth as he's shaping this molten glass with sparks and smoke and flame and steam flying in all directions. I love that image. I'm going to use the arrow keys to find exactly the shot that I want. I want to be able to use this maybe for marketing or export as a still frame. How do I mark a frame? Type the letter M. Notice here, there's a little house-like symbol. That's a marker that we can move to. Type the letter M a second time. When the playhead is parked on it, we can give the marker a name, Flames and Glasses. Bum, bum, bum. Click here. It becomes a to-do, which is uncompleted or completed. We'll talk more about that in a future chapter. I can even convert it to a chapter marker. If you want to save the marker, click Done. If you want to delete the marker, which I do here, click Delete. Let's just set another marker. Type the letter M. To jump to a marker, hold the control key down, control semicolon, jumps back to a marker, and control apostrophe, jumps forward to a marker. Control semicolon, jumps back, control apostrophe, jumps forward. Markers are really cool, and they're always attached to the clip, so wherever the clip moves, the marker moves with it. By default, Final Cut keeps all your clips together. However, you have full control over where clips are located and how they are moved. There is a lot more we can do to organize clips in the timeline, and Chapter 9 covers these options in detail. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks.